We are studying the one-dimensional quantum harmonic oscillator using algebraic techniques with the creation and annihilation operators. So this is the creation operator, A dagger. A is the annihilation operator because it's annihilating the ground state. And we wrote the something called the generating function. This generating function has an interesting property because it's an eigenvector of the non-Hermitian operator A, the annihilation operator. Let us see how. So let's take it from here. This is A e to the lambda A dagger 0. Then we want to take A to the right. A first the commutator 0 plus e to the lambda A dagger A 0. This annihilates 0. And we did this commutator before, so it is lambda e to the lambda A dagger 0. But this is just the generating function, lambda psi lambda. Lambda is in general complex. That's okay because A is not a Hermitian operator. Because X and P are Hermitian, but we have an I here. And its Hermitian conjugate is X minus IP, which is not this. So, okay, so let's write this important relation. A psi lambda is equal to lambda psi lambda. And the conjugate equation is psi lambda A dagger equals psi lambda times lambda star, the complex conjugate. All right, and yes, let's write that on top. Psi lambda is equal to e to the lambda A dagger 0. I am erasing the rest. Now, what about this construct? Psi mu, psi lambda, which is 0, e to the mu star A, e to the lambda A dagger 0. Let me call this psi lambda. So psi lambda is an eigenvector of A. Therefore, this is equal to 0 e to the mu star lambda times psi lambda e to the lambda A 0 psi lambda. This is a complex number. We can take it out. E to the mu star lambda 0 e to the lambda A dagger 0. So if you expand it, 1 plus lambda A dagger, etc. A daggers will kill that 1. So only 1 survives. 0, 0 is normalized. It's 1. So it is simply e to the mu star lambda. If you want to play, you can expand this thing into powers of mu star A. And for each A, you can take the commutator, but this is very short. So psi mu psi lambda is equal to E mu star lambda. I'm erasing it. Now, these generating functions are very useful, these psi lambdas. For example, let us take this one, this relation. Namely, we can read off the orthonormality of these states, which we proved earlier, again, but in a very simple way, like this. Psi lambda is equal to sum over m and n mu star m lambda n over root m factorial n factorial m n. We just computed this overlap. That's e mu star lambda. That's equal to n mu star n lambda n over n factorial. Now we compare this part and that part. Now what do we see? First, the powers of mu and lambda are the same here. They are both raised to the n power and summed over. What about here? There is a mixed sum. There is an m and n, but they have to be equal. That means those terms with m not equal to n must not appear. That's because this is zero. So m has to be equal to n. Next, suppose m is equal to n, then what? We have here on the left-hand side, so this is the left side, this is the right side. On the left side, we have mu star n, lambda n. I'm looking at m equals n. So it is n factorial times nn. This must be equal to the same power, mu star n, lambda n over n factorial. So what do we see from here? Nn is equal to 1. Okay. And mn, therefore, is equal to delta mn. 0 if m is not equal to n. 1 if... But the proof is so easy this way. Now, there are other computations that we shall do, which makes life very easy doing it this way, this algebraic way. I'm erasing this part. So just from here, we can read off that the oscillator states are orthonormal. This is gone. Now we shall compute this, psi lambda x, psi lambda. X is an operator. X we can read off from here, a plus a dagger is 2x over root 2. So this is psi lambda a plus a dagger over root 2 psi lambda. So this is psi lambda is an eigenvector of A. Psi lambda bra is the eigenvector of A dagger. So the result is trivial lambda lambda star over root 2 times, psi mu. I'm taking this general over psi mu. Psi mu. Psi lambda, because eigenvector means it is A psi lambda is equal to lambda psi lambda. So we know this result. This is lambda plus, this is mu star plus lambda. So this is mu star plus lambda divided by root 2 times e to the mu star lambda. But if you open it with m and n states, this one is sum over m, sum over n, mu star over to the m, root m factorial lambda to the n root m factorial m x n. This is equal to mu star plus lambda e to the mu star lambda over root 2. Without doing any calculation, we can see something. When you expand it, exponential, you will have equal powers of mu star lambda. Mu star to the 5, lambda to the 5, divided by 5 factorial, etc. It goes like this. But it is multiplied by a term mu star plus lambda. So on the right-hand side, such a term is missing. Mu star to the k, lambda to the k, missing. Equal powers missing. Because either mu star has one more power or lambda has one more power. So equal powers are missing. So we can read immediately n x n for all n that's equal to zero. Okay. Now the question is, what are the non-zero ones? Obviously, they will differ by one. Okay, so let's, for example, expand. So, again, let me call this right side, the left side. Now, I am looking on the right side. A term, let's say, mu star n plus 1 lambda n over root 2 times n factorial, and this has to be equal on the left hand side. I'm looking at the equal powers of mu star and lambda. So mu star m is n plus 1. So mu star, this is the left hand side, mu star n plus 1, m is lambda n. Then I have n plus 1 xn divided by root n plus 1 factorial n factorial. So they will have to be equal. Right side equal to the left. I wrote this one to the left, this one to the right. It doesn't matter. Let's get a space. So these are the same. So n plus 1 x n equals 1 over root 2 root n plus 1 n factorial square divided by n factorial, so this thing cancels, we found it out. So this is n plus 1 x n is equal to 1 over root 2, or let me write like this, root n plus 1 over 2. Clearly, this, since the right hand side is real, this is equal, and x is Hermitian, this is equal to also nx n plus 1 is equal to root n plus 1 over 2. Next, I'm erasing this part. Let's erase a bit more because we will remember this. So n plus 1 x n is equal to root n plus 1 over 2. And n x n is equal to 0. Next, we look at psi mu x square psi lambda. So the procedure is clear. We will write x square in terms of a and a dagger. So I'm erasing. So it is psi mu a plus a dagger over root 2 a plus a dagger over root 2 psi lambda. So the procedure is clear. We will try to get a's to the right because psi lambda is an eigenvector of a, and we will move a daggers to the left because psi mu bra is the eigenvector of a dagger. So let's see this. I have 1/2 psi mu. I have a square, then a dagger square. Then I have a dagger a. That's okay. They are in proper order. But then I have a dagger plus a dagger psi lambda. Now I want to change the order. So this is a dagger plus a dagger a. So this is just 1. A dagger a makes it 2. So I have 1/2 psi mu a square plus a dagger square plus 2 a dagger a plus 1 times psi lambda. And the evaluation is immediate because coherent states are eigenvectors of these operators. So it's equal to 1/2. We simply write lambda square plus mu star square plus 2 mu star lambda plus 1 times psi mu psi lambda, which is e to the mu star lambda. Remember, this is psi mu psi lambda. Okay. That is equal to, so let's call this the left part. That's equal to, now I open this up in terms of the oscillator states. Sum over m and n, mu star m, lambda n over root m factorial n factorial, m x square n. And by comparing the like same powers of mu star and lambda, we will read off the matrix elements of x square. Okay, I will just need this one. Let me erase this. Before we do some algebra, we can see a few things. One, this term and that term. This will correspond to n plus 2. This will correspond to n plus 2. And these terms, because when you expand mu star lambda, they have the same powers. So this has the same power. This has the zeroth power. So this gives me the diagonal component, and these give me the non-diagonal component. So let me go for the diagonal component first. Okay. So I have from the left side, I'm just looking at the diagonal. Diagonal for x square. Okay. So for the diagonal on the right side, so this is the right side, this is the left side. So on the right side, for the coefficients of mu star n, lambda n, I have n x square n divided by n factorial. On the left part, because I have mu star lambda here, I have to pick the mu star n minus 1, lambda n minus 1. So it is 2s will cancel. So mu star n lambda n. Actually, let me write them like this. Mu star lambda times mu star n minus 1. Lambda n minus 1. These are coming from the exponential. These are from here. 2's canceled. And all right. And the power of this. Powers. So the exponential is n minus 1 factorial. That should be equal to that. So these powers are the same. N x square n part A, let's say part, I'm calling this part A, this part B. Part A is over n factorial. Is equal to 1 over n minus 1 factorial. So which gives me n factorial, which is just n. The next term is 1/2. So 1/2 1/2 term coming from the left. It is 1/2 mu star n lambda n over n factorial, this is from the left, and from the right, again the same thing, mu star n lambda n over n factorial, n x square n part b. Part b is coming from this 1/2, so it's sum of part a and part b. So it is simply giving 1/2. So n x square n, I'm summing part A and part B, so it is simply is equal to n plus 1/2. So let's write it here. These were for the x's, and n x square n is equal to n plus 1/2. I am racing. Now we look at the non-diagonal terms. Let's see. So we pick one of them. Let's pick lambda square. So from the left, we have mu star n lambda n times lambda square over n factorial. And I have 1 over 2, so 2. So from the right, I have lambda n will have to be n plus 2, m will be n. So mu star, I use the same powers, n lambda n plus 2 over root n factorial n plus 2 factorial times n x n plus 2. So these terms have to be equal. N x n plus x square n plus 2 is equal to 1 over 2 so this is n plus 2 n plus 1 times n factorial, so which cancels, so it is n plus 1 n plus 2. Since this is a real term, this is also equal to n plus 2, so x square n, which is again the same thing. So I can write here n x square n plus 2 equals n plus 2 x square n. I can erase this part. Can one do it? Can. N plus 2 x square n. That's equal to 1 over 2 root n plus 1 n plus 2. Okay, I'm erasing this part. So, I want to give you as a problem to do NPN, which will be 0, then you will do N plus 1 PN and NPN plus 1 and also NP square N plus 2 and N plus 2 P square N. But I want to indicate something before I go. I leave that to you as a homework. What is P? I want to set up P square. 2IP is equal to, if I subtract, this is A minus A dagger over root 2 2IP over root 2 is A minus A dagger, so it is root 2. So P is minus I A minus A dagger over root 2. Let us look at psi mu p square psi lambda. This is psi mu. P square is minus I square A minus A dagger A minus A dagger over 2 psi lambda. So it is minus psi mu, let's multiply that, 1 half. I have a square plus a dagger square minus a dagger a minus a dagger psi lambda. And this we change a dagger commutator plus a dagger A comes with a minus sign. and this is 1. Now it's in normal order. So it is psi mu minus 1/2 This gives me lambda square plus mu star square minus 2 mu star lambda minus 1/2 times psi lambda. It looks like a new computation, but it really is not. For example, look at the diagonal terms of x square. It came from 1/2 2 mu star lambda plus 1 e to the. And here it is the same thing. So p square is the diagonal terms are just the same. So I can write immediately. Where is it? I didn't put the diagonal. So the diagonal term n p square n is just n plus 1/2. You see, it's so trivial. And this is lambda square plus mu square terms are coming with a minus sign. So I gave it as a homework, but I already did. So n plus 2 p square n is equal to n p square n plus 2. And it is equal to minus these, minus 1/2 n plus 1 n plus 2 square root. I am erasing certain parts. These I don't need anymore. So you see, for example, n p square over 2 plus x square over 2, that's just the energy, right? N. So if n plus 1/2 over 2, so it is 2 times n plus 1/2 over 2, that's equal to n plus 1/2. And since the p square plus 2 x square plus 2, that's the energy, this diagonal in the number operators eigenstates, you expect n plus 2, for example, this is hn to be 0. In fact, p square non-diagonal term and x square non-diagonal term have the opposite values. This is minus, whereas this is plus, and they cancel as you expect. Okay, so we also, I'm erasing, we also got the but these terms are not equal to the x because of the imaginary signs I. One comes with a plus I and minus the other one with a minus I, and I leave that to you to find out. I'm erasing this part. So now, delta xn is xn x square and n minus n xn square. This is 0, we found out. And this is n plus 1/2, root n plus 1/2. This is square, delta xn is n plus 1/2. So same thing with the momentum, because diagonal element is 0, diagonal element of p square is the same, so delta pn is equal to root n plus 1/2. So delta xn, delta pn is equal to and plus a half. And notice that for n equals 0, delta x 0, delta p 0 is uncertainty is 1 half. This is the minimum possible value for the oscillator states, but also you can prove this is the absolute minimum in quantum physics. That we shall not do, but this is the uncertainty relations. All right, we will finish up by writing the coordinate representation of these functions. I'm erasing this. We are done with the matrix elements. Representing these functions in the coordinates space, namely, we found that n was equal to 1 over root n factorial a dagger to the n 0. And the coordinate space means representation is xn. The component of this vector in the coordinate space is 1 over root n factorial. Now a dagger. A dagger is x minus I 1 over I d by dx to the n times psi 0 x. So this goes away. So what is this? Well, this is a complicated operator. It's the nth power of this operator. Can we recognize something here? This is x minus d by dx n. Let us use the following trick. X minus d by dx f. F is a test function. Is equal to x f minus f prime. Now the same thing we can write in this form. E to the x square over 2 minus d by dx times e to the minus x square over 2 times f. The operator is acting both on that one and on that one. Okay, so it is e to the x square over 2. Now, when it acts on this, it is minus minus, so it is xf, and then minus, when it acts on this, f prime, times e to the minus x square over 2, but there is no operation on it, it's just a multiplier, I can put it here. In fact, so they cancel, xf is equal to xf prime, so this inequality. Now, coming back to the nth power, xn is equal to 1 over root n factorial. Now, e to the x square over 2. If you repeat this operator n times, each time, for example, in the second one, the second power will be like this. X minus d by dx square f will be e to the x square over 2, then minus d by dx, e to the minus x square over 2, times, I'm squaring, e to the x square over 2, minus d by dx, e to the minus x square over 2, f. So the intermediates will give me 1, so I have e to the x square over 2, minus d by dx, to the square, e to the minus x square over 2, f. It is acting on both e to the minus x square and f. So I have here the nth power. Now I can erase this because I know the operator. This is equal to 1 over equals 1 over root factorial. Sorry. A dagger has a 1 over root 2 in it. So it is root 2 to the n. Okay. A dagger is x minus ip over root 2. So we begin e to the x square over 2 minus d by dx to the power n. There it was 2, now n, times e to the minus x square over 2, but it is acting on psi 0 x, and we solved for it. It is 1 over pi 1 over 4 e to the minus x square over 2. So you can multiply these two. And from the Rodriguez formula, we know minus d by dx n e to the minus x square is equal to hn x e to the minus x square. Because if I bring it here, it is e to the plus x square. That was the Rodriguez formula. So it's Rodriguez formula written in another way. Let me write it here, Rodriguez. So this is equal to, I have here 1 over root 2 to the n. So I have 1 over pi 1 fourth, 1 over root 2 to the n, n factorial, times hn of x, times e to the minus x square over 2. This is minus x square, but I am multiplying by e to the plus x square over 2, so the result is minus 1 over 2 x square. So perhaps I write it here cleanly. Xn is equal to 1 over pi 1 fourth 1 over root 2 to the n, n factorial, hn x e to the minus x square over 2. Let us remember that this is the operator x minus d by dx. Okay. I am erasing this part. How about its representation in the momentum space? Pn is equal to 1 over root n factorial times 1 over root 2 to the n times minus I d by dp minus ip. Minus 1 over I. To the n psi 0 p. So this is the same thing. 1 over pi 1 fourth e to the minus p square over 2. Instead of x, I wrote 2. Let's look at this operator. This is, if I take it up, I. So it is minus I to the n, p minus d by dp to the n. So the same type of operator, except I have this factor. So we can write pn as 1 over pi, 1 over 4, 1 over 2n, n factorial, hn, but this time of p, e to the minus p square over 2. So these are the oscillator functions in the coordinate space and the momentum space. Remember, these are just the Hermite polynomials. All right, as a last step, let us write the coordinate representation of the generating function. Let me just erase all this. Psi lambda is equal to n lambda to the n over root n factorial n. So x psi lambda is xn. For xn, we write that whole thing. Sorry, I had here minus I to the n. Remember, we had x minus d by dx, and we had p minus d by dp times I, so raise minus I. So when you raise to the power n, that's how the minus I to the n comes. Coming back to here, we will now put what we have found for xn. So it is equal to n 1 over pi 1 over 4 lambda to the n root n factorial. I am here, now I am writing xn. Pi over 4 is here. 1 over root 2 to the n factorial hn x e to the minus x square over 2. So pi 1 over 4 e to the minus x square over 2, they do not depend on the index n. We take them out. It's equal to 1 over pi 1 over 4 e to the minus x square over 2. Now n factorial comes out, n factorial. And this is hn of x. And this is lambda over root 2 to the power n. Lambda over root 2 to the power n. But do you recognize this thing? Remember when doing the analytic solution, in the complex plane, we obtained the generating function of the Hermite polynomials. It was g xh was sum over n h to the n h n x over n factorial. So if you compare here, instead of h, we have lambda over 2, and we had obtained the value for it. It is e to the 2 x h minus h square. So this is nothing but e to the minus x square over 2 over pi 1 over 4 g x lambda over root 2. So we simply will write g using that psi lambda of x is equal to 1 over pi 1 over 4 e to the minus x square over 2 e to the 2 lambda over root 2. So 2 root 2 x lambda times e to the minus lambda square over 2. That is, this part is e to the 2x lambda over root 2, and this is e to the minus lambda over root 2 square. So if you let me write this magical function, which looks much more simpler than the oscillator functions. E to the minus lambda square over 2, e to the root 2 x lambda e to the minus x square over 2. This is x e to the lambda a dagger 0. So we have seen that we can obtain the all the expectation values of the x and p operators using this, and the fact that it's an eigenvalue of the annihilation operator with the eigenvalue lambda. And so we have also obtained the coordinate and the momentum representations of the oscillator states, their uncertainty products. And we also obtained the coordinate representation of the this generating function, which is not normalized, but it's a very interesting function and carries a wealth of information that we will pick up in the next lecture.